You do like these road trips.
Yeah.
And I'm jealous of these things. We've talked about that before, and you like these crazy fast motorcycles. Then this time, you did a new thing. You rented a car.
No, I bought a car. I was making this Miles Davis film with Don in Cincinnati, and I had to be in New York for something. And I thought, all my family went to Europe for the holidays while I went to work.
So you're by yourself.
So I'm by myself with my dog, and I thought, I've crossed the states. I'll go to New York and I'll drive to Cincinnati, make the movie with Don, and then I'll drive back to L.A.
See, I'm saying, that sense of adventure.
But I've done it.
I would just fly to New York.
Right. So I did it. I've done it a couple of times on a motorcycle, which I enjoyed very much. But I thought, you've got to cross America in an old British two-seater sports car, don't you?
Yeah, you actually put out some time and energy into thinking and driving and getting there, and it makes you feel more satisfied when you're there.
I came up with a great costume. I had a costume. Because I'm an actor, you know, I think these things through. I thought,
what
am I going to wear? So I got myself, what am I going to wear? I've got to look right in this car. I got a blue, I had it taken in, it was a bit baggy. It was a all-in-one blue, like a sort of French, like a French mechanic. Or maybe a sort of 1960s French helicopter pilot outfit.
Yeah, like a $6 million
man. Zips this way.
Yeah, like a unitard.
And it zips that way, so you can have a pee. So then I was in Utah. Suddenly I went over the border, and it's like driving into the moon or Mars or something. It's just nothing.
Oh, I heard it's beautiful.
It's so beautiful. And I was watching my petrol, my gas gauge, just going, oh dear. Well, I pulled onto the side, and I thought, someone will come along and help. And
welcome to Utah, buddy.
So there I was. Now listen, this isn't an anti-Utah thing.
No.
I've done that in the past. This is not an anti-Utah.
No.
But I found the only bit of paper I had was my license for the car, and I wrote gas and a big question mark. And I sat on my car like this. As monstrously huge, you know, vehicles that are destroying the earth are going past me, sucking gasoline into their massive engines, and I'm sitting there with nobody stopped.
Gas?
Nobody.
No.
Somebody went past with a trailer with three quad bikes, and I could see red petrol cans. I could see the gas slopping around.
Three going by.
Inside it, I was like,
yeah, that's exactly what you're getting inside. You nailed it. Yeah, no.
But he was like, French hairdresser. Oh, no. No.
They didn't do it.
So this lovely lady, Madeline, I see a motorbike coming, so I even put the thing down because I thought, well, she's not going to have any. Here she is.
Yeah.
Saved me, and she's a long distance motorcycle adventurer. She's an amazing woman. She teaches in the Boston area, and she stopped and she came up and asked if I was all right. I said, I've run out of petrol, and she went, oh. She went back to her bike. She had 2 1-liter canisters full of gasoline, and she gave them to me, and didn't want to take any money, and she was so sweet.
Did she recognize who you were?
No, she didn't know who I was, and I said, I never say this, I was really embarrassed saying about it. Do you know who I am? And she went, no. And I said, well,
I would have freaked out if I'm driving through the desert. I'm like, Obi-Wan? Did I die? Did I hit a rock, or did I die? Well, that's Obi-Wan. No, what's going on, man? I would have freaked out. I would have went nuts and, like, dressed as a French dude with the scarf and your dog is talking. I go, this is like a surrealist dream. Yeah. But so she didn't know.
She didn't know.
Just being
and
nice.
I said, I didn't bring up, do you know who I am, because I'm an actor, but because I've done lots of long-distance motorcycle touring.
Yeah.
And I've made 2 documentaries called Long Way Round and Long Way Down about my trips around the Northern Hemisphere and down through Africa. And she had heard about that me, you know. She went, oh, yes. And I said, did you see my trips Long Way Round? And she hadn't seen them. So we've stayed in touch. We're friends now, and I've sent them to her. And she came to see the play a couple of weeks ago. It's so nice.
Because the reason why I like the story is also because you're actually a really nice guy, but also that you've kept in touch with her. And this was her first play on Broadway that she saw, or no?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe.
That's the whole reason I like the story.
Yes, it was.
I just make that up.
I don't know. It's my first play on Broadway.
Just call her before the show airs.
Yeah.
let's
do the yes version.
All right. Now this. This was the reason why I like the story is this is.
Come on.
This is your first Broadway play that you're doing, and this is the first Broadway play that she's ever seen.
Yes.
Yes. Great story, isn't that great?